Thank you. diğer hocalarımız vardı. Çok ilkaçını kazım sakın bir sesi yok. Kuvvet teşkil ettiriyorlar. Ama ben yavrum sen teşkil ettiriyorum. Anzurcaya nasıl bu dedim. Right, okay. So now, before we actually think of computing this stuff, there comes from a global observation, in fact, it's not here. Can you tell me first, and it's absolutely dramatic observation, which is in total structure over estimate. If you ask yourself, how do these functions look like? I mean, and again, I mean, think of the computer way. Yeah, you take another system to a computer. And what you find is that the correlation function, and in fact, all of them, that's what we can pretty much all correlation functions can correlate, depends on three things. Parametricity. So data is one, you have to measure energy from unit, data is an extra unit. If you see on the top, which one is happening, which of the 10? And number three, nothing else. So that is the algorithm. I'm only the algorithm, of course, yeah. So that algorithm means, it means the following question after the algorithm, you have such a spectrum. Now, by having that tells you that we can translate energies to pounds, right? Energies into a pound. So if you ask for correlations between very different levels, so far apart that the energy separation, the inverse of the energy separation corresponds to a time scale shorter than the algorithm, then you lose universality. But on shorter energy scales, when you quote more times, you have fully established universality, no matter whether you are looking at a complex nucleus or a solid or a heavy molecule system. So that is just your energy category. So that's an absolutely stunning observation, which was made jeder der Stelle, die die fallen, ein Ensemble, Session Function, Ensemble, Statistical Ensemble, nämlich in der Everything würde, auf Model Systems, auf Model Hamiltonian, and the question is, of course, how do we define this ensemble? And we declare three, four groups, and we give a subject to four different criteria. First of all, we fix n, which is the dimension of the data set we're interested in, yeah, right, the region, the number of errors we're interested in. So let's consider what the last number is, n is last, yeah. Second, fix data, which is to say that we agree on a certain characteristic energy scale, over these n levels, and bandwidth over n that defines data. You can also say you define the bandwidth of the Hamiltonian and n, and the data defines data. Three, the class. And now comes the interesting fourth part. Randomness is an essential point, and we do not put the theory upside down. We demand the Hamiltonian, our ensemble, to be maximally random given this one to three. As random as it could possibly. Of course, you will ask what it means, I can understand. But in Schermann, so we are talking about an ensemble, so we need a probability distribution similar to the one. So much that now for a problem of Hamiltonians and not for a quantity distribution. A T of H, that we have to ask on for good measure here, on the measure of Hamiltonians. And we determine this such that it maximizes bandwidth and integrity consistency entropy, information entropy, subject to the risk quantity. Information. For this round, you can say, let's compute information entropy, which is log p, p and then average, for a given distribution, and maximize that subject to this rule which you encode in terms of certain dimensional class. And that's how you can compute it. And equivalently, you can try to get one intuitively. What would you think of? What would be the maximum random Hamiltonian to think of? How would you? Hamiltonian part in the Schermann matrix, yeah? The question is, come up with a distribution of this matrix element, statistical, such that you believe you have models. So wat het is, ja, is van met de kritische dus de tweede week blijft het zegt samen van nul. Ja, zo is de Gaussian rate voor het eerste element in de video niet. Hoe de frequent zijn n over n root square. En zit daarmee, dat is een hele grote dat 1, 2 en 4, depending on which sum of the gaps are. Nu, let's just say now, right? Beta is 1, 2 en 4, en de gap is A1, A. Ik wil niet herhalen, hoe kan je hebben, maar ik heb het identical set, dat je hebt een problem, because you tell the name of this position, dat is echt corner. En de corner is hier een mental view, which is like a hell. En ik vraag de question, do I have the name of this position, and I compute the answer? Do you need answer to the position of the two plus? Omdat is hier die answer. En ik zeg, ik denk, alle rules van het problem. Ik wil het uit, moet het sensitive dependent with this position, dan you have a problem. Dit is the simplest and the best alignment with this position. Now, there is crowds of mathematicians who spend their lifetime with figuring out how is one can generalize this position before something happens. And so you can generate a good field of academia. Fucking on this topic. Yeah. Expectation values.